Jonathan Ashworth, thank you very much.
7 minutes to 9. The musician and singer Anushka Shankar has become the first president of the F List, an initiative launched today to improve women's representation in the music industry and in lineups at festivals and events. It grew out of the work done by campaigner Vic Bain to set up a directory of all female musicians, songwriters, composers and bands in the UK.
The problem for women in the UK music industry is they are still in the minority when it comes to professional work. Only 14% of those signed to music publishing companies are women. Only 20% of musicians signed to record labels are women. And about 15% of festival headliners are women. So they don't have much presence professionally, even though they consist of nearly half of all music degree students over the past 5 or 6 years. We want women in the music industry to be able to more successfully start and sustain their careers because of the work that we are going to do. We're going to raise awareness. We're going to create initiatives to help facilitate training and career development. We are going to increase knowledge about gender inequality. We want to be a major authority for promoting women in music.
Vic Bain, well, I asked Anushka Shankar, who went into the industry with a famous name, her father being Ravi Shankar, why she decided to spearhead the F List.
There was just a serendipity between when I was looking at this in my own life and my own career and Vic Bain creating the F List. It's something that I've really been looking at in the last couple of years and trying to correct. I noticed, for example, that even as a female artist and as a self-proclaimed feminist my whole life, I was hiring way more male musicians than female, and it was something I had to try and actively correct. I realized it takes active work to make a correction.
So I suppose most people will think of the very high profile figures in the industry and probably not realize that it's so far off 50-50.
It's so far off 50-50, but as you say, there's a sort of prominence of the really famous pop stars, let's say, across gender. And so it can look a bit more even than it really is, even though that's not even. But it gets worse if you drop off into behind the scenes a bit more, or if you start looking at band members, for example, the ratio drops significantly. So
why is it that way?
I don't know if I can answer why it's that way about music specifically, other than that music is emblematic of society as a whole. And so it has historically been that way. And women have been underrepresented historically. And so there is a need to actively correct that. And I remember there was a moment, I think it was 3-4 years ago, 2017, when there was really a lot of furor around the underrepresentation of women in festivals. Since then, that created the push and the support so that people started trying to correct it. And I think that was around when Vic Bain started compiling this list as well. So it was just kind of the idea that people sort of say, oh, I don't know how to fix this, or I don't know where the women are. And that may be an excuse, or it may be genuine bafflement, because it's the relationships that people already have in music that will be the easiest path to tread. You'll go back to the same guitarist, you'll go back to the same bassist that you've always worked with, of course.
And would you say that you have faced that in the difficulty of getting booked to be part of a festival lineup, for example? Because you did come into this industry with a name that immediately resonated with people because Ravi Shankar is your father.
Exactly as you say. I mean, there are so many intersections of prejudice and privilege that even though I'm a woman, you know, I had a very, very recognizable name that's synonymous with the instrument I play. So to an extent, if someone wants to book someone to play a sitar, they might come to me first. So I'm very, very fortunate to have that. There aren't that many people who do what I do. I imagine if there were 10 other sitarists at the same level as me that lived in London that were male, then it might be a slightly different story. I've got a kind of intersection of a privilege there. But definitely as a musician with 25 years in the industry, I have seen how women just aren't booked the same way as men.
In the album that you did earlier this year, your most recent album, Love Letters, most of your collaborations on that are other women. Did that just happen, or was that a deliberate choice?
It was actually both. Initially, it just happened because of the content of the music, the type of songs I were writing very much felt like women's stories, and I gravitated towards female co-writers. But as an intersection between my personal creative process and what was going on in the music industry at large, I realized that I needed to put my money where my mouth was and look to actively correct. So not just the female collaborators I was naturally gravitating towards, I also actively searched for female instrumentalists. And then beyond that, female co-producers, female engineers, you know, to really have women on board the project at every layer.
And they were there. Was the lesson, if you
there.
Look hard enough, they are there.
They're absolutely there. And that's the thing I can't stress enough about this list. It's literally a database. You can go to the website and search by instrument or by genre or by location, and you'll get a list of women who are right there doing exactly what it is that you need. And I'm sure as the list continues to grow, you know, it will become more and more thorough, but it's already staggering.
Anushka Shankar, thank you very much.
Pleasure. Thank you.
That is